Hello, I'm Helen Bradley. Welcome to this video tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to apply a split tone and vignette effect in Lightroom. Before we have a look at how we would apply a split tone effect to an image, let's have a look at an image that has a split tone effect already applied to it. This is a piece of graffiti I shot in Brick Lane in London, and it has been converted to a black and white image, and a split tone effect has been applied to it. You'll find that you probably get best results with split toning on a black and white image. And what split toning allows you to do is to color the highlights in the image one color and the shadows another color. So let's just wind this back to the original image. I've just clicked here and I'll click Ctrl Z to undo the split toning, and let's have a look and see how we would convert this image to black and white and how we would then go ahead and apply a split tone effect to it. Now this is the image as it was as a color image, and the first thing that I'll do is basically just fix the image. So I want to make sure that the exposure is good on it and that clarity is pretty good, so I get some sharpness in the image, not worrying too much about the color because I'm about to remove that by converting to black and white by clicking on this B and W icon here. The next thing is to see if I can get something a little bit better out of the black and white image by converting some of these colors to dark and some to light. So I'm just working around these magentas and purple because there was an area in the image here that had those colors in it, and I can make them a lot darker. But there was a lot of blue in the image too, so I'm going to walk that up towards being light and just adjust these other colors down a little bit. And I got a bit of a reaction there from one of the colors, perhaps too much of a reaction. I might take yellow up a bit, but you're going to work until you get a nice black and white in the image and then open the split toning panel. The best thing to do when you start with split toning is to wind the saturation up, because until you have saturation set at a reasonable level, you won't see the hues as you apply them, so you'll just be pointing to a color and not being able to see any effect at all. Now I like to work with colors that are sort of opposite each other, and I think I've just hit on a really, really good combination here. This sort of green and red color, they're opposite each other on the color wheel. They fight each other quite a bit and they look really good when you have them applied then as a duotone or a split tone. And then I'm just going to wind back the saturation a little bit because it probably was a bit intense for me, particularly in the greens. And then I can adjust the balance between the two colors. This winds the balance back towards the shadows, so a lot more of the image is being counted as shadows and has this red color applied to it. If I go forward, then a lot more of the image is being classed as highlights, and so it has more green. So this allows me to tweak the point at which red stops and green starts to get the effect that I want. Now a vignette, which I'm going to add to the image, is done using this effects option here, and we want a post crop vignette because I have actually cropped this image and I don't want to use a lens correction vignette. So I'm going to wind in a negative direction to add a darker vignette around the edge of the image. I'm going to adjust the midpoint out a bit, and let's just see about roundness. I really want to force some of the color into the very edges of the image, so I'm thinking that that might be a fairly good result. Want a bit of feathering as well. So I'm just going to tweak that until I get what I want. I prefer to use highlight priority or color priority and not paint overlay for my vignette. So let's see where we've come from. This was the image before it was converted to black and white, and then we converted it to black and white. And then we applied our split toning to it. And then we finished off with a post-crop vignette. I'm Helen Bradley. Thank you for joining me for this video tutorial. If you like the tutorial, please click the like button and think about subscribing to my YouTube channel, where you'll be advised when new videos are released. And visit my website at projectwoman.com for more tips, tricks, and tutorials on Photoshop, Lightroom, Illustrator, and other applications.